Hello, guys. Arnasona Films, or Mal, as you prefer here. And today, I'm going to be answering all your questions that you left on the 5th anniversary Q&A announcement video and the community tab. I've actually been thinking on doing a Q&A to celebrate the 5th anniversary of my YouTube channel, which is today, even though my first video on this channel would not be posted until August 14th. I did do one in like 2018, back when I used that clunky old camera that rarely showed any high quality video, but I don't really like to talk about it anymore because it wasn't very good. And I tried to do one in like 2019, but it didn't really go very well. But this year, I decided to do one to celebrate the 5th anniversary of my YouTube channel. So, let's get started. Question 1. What other shows did you like other than Thomas? Well, I like Tugs, Feed or Tugboat, Bob the Builder, mostly the original, not the 2015 reboot. But when it comes to the 2015 Bob the Builder, I don't want to sound too much like James A. Williams. Fireman Sam, well, seasons 1 to 5, I don't know why I thought the CGI version was passable when I first saw it. Pingu, Morph, Shaun the Sheep, Mr. Bean, Tom and Jerry, The Simpsons, and Rex to Run, which I started watching last year. Question 2. What was the first Thomas merchandise you ever owned? I think it was like a little push and go Thomas. That, alongside some Ertl toys that used to belong to my brother Jordan, and the Brio Thomas, James and Percy I said in the little wooden rally collection video with the out of sync audio. Question 3. Looks like you've been on YouTube longer than I have. Is that right? Yeah. I suppose so. Question 4. Have you finished a new episode where I've voiced Arthur in your series? Not quite. I'm still waiting for, like, lines for Sir Handel, James, and Henry, then I can continue work. Question 5. What is your favourite letter? I'm not sure. Question 6. What's your favourite colour from the rainbow? Blue. Question 7. What's your favourite number? I remember it around primary school back in 2012, I said my favourite number is the number 1 because it's the same number as Thomas and Scarlowe and Godred, even though he was scrapped. And, Glynn doesn't really count because this was like before The Adventure Begins was released. Question 8. What's your favourite character from Thomas and Friends? My favourite Thomas characters are Henry, Gordon, Percy, Toby, Duck, Donald and Douglas, Oliver, Boko, Duke, Scarlowe, Peter Sam, Duncan, Stepney, Derek, Diesel 10, Harvey, Emily, well, her portrayal in Season 7 and the Andrew Brenner seasons at least. Molly, Rosie, Whiff, Hank, Hero, Scruff, Paxton, Luke, Connor, Timothy, Ryan, Flying Scotsman, Merlin, Philip, and Rebecca, which is a controversial opinion. Question 9. Do you know how long you've been filming the scenes when you're outdoors? I'd say, like, close to, like, 7 years, because I remember when I, like, first... Remember, like, the first videos I filmed outdoors at my old house were, like, a... some wooden railway remakes I made of, like, the three railway engines and Thomas and Gordon and Thomas's train. This was before I made the Thomas and Gordon remake for the 35th anniversary of the TV series, by the way. And before I did that remake of Thomas's train with George Carlin's narration. And also a little series called the South Wales Valley Railway, which only lasted for like 5 episodes, I believe. But I haven't posted it to YouTube. What's your favorite episode from Thomas and Friends? Okay, I'm probably gonna go with, like, the Flying Kipper. The Flying Kipper, the Duck and the Diesel trilogy, Escape, the Grandpuff episodes, Duncan Gets Spooked, and Haunted Henry as well, Percy's Chocolate Crunch, I'm not sure about Season 7. I'm gonna have to go with the Runaway Elephant for that one. Season 8, probably Edward the Great. Season 9, Respect for Gordon. Season 10, It's Good to be Gordon, a bit of a guilty pleasure of mine. Season 11, Wash Behind Your Buffers. Season 12, Heave Ho Thomas. Season 13, Tickle Pink. Season 14, maybe Thomas and Scruff. Season 15 and 16 were pretty terrible, so I don't have a favourite episode from those seasons. Season 17, The Thomas Way. Season 18, Duncan and the Grumpy Passenger. Season 19, maybe the Christmas episodes, like Diesel's Ghost at Christmas. And I thought The Beast of Soda was pretty funny. A Cranky Christmas and Snow Place Like Home. Season 20, The Small Railway episodes. Season 21, Terrence Breaks the Ice. Season 22, School of Duck. Season 23, Heart of Gold and Free the Roads. And season 24, Thomas the Royal Engine. Question 11, I believe? Have you watched PBS shows before? Okay, I never really watched PBS since I born in the UK, and I mostly watched, like, Nick Jr. and CBeebies, but I'm gonna go with, like, Angelina Ballerina, a show I liked as a kid, but not anymore, and Clifford the Big Red Dog. Haven't watched the show in a long time, but the last time I watched Clifford was with Clifford's Really Big Movie in around 2016. No, I have not seen the Clifford the Big Red Dog movie that came out last year, and I think Clifford's Really Big Movie is a lot better. Question 12. What do you know what is 10 add 10? 20? I could be wrong, though. Question 13. What is your favourite British Rail diesel? Bit of a tough one there. I'm probably gonna go with the BR Class 42 Warship. Question 13. What, White Star Line or Cunard? Don't know what it is. Question 15. What is your top 5 favorite Thomas movies? The Great Discovery, because it was such a great send-off to the model series, unlike season 12. Wait, and in case you didn't know, I hate season 12 because it's pretty bad. and it's the worst models, and it's probably the worst after models to use. Number two, Hero of the Rails, which when I first saw it, it was around the time I start, in which after number two, Hero of the Rails, which after I first saw the movie, I started to warm up to CGI Thomas and Friends after not being satisfied with season 12. And even though the nitrogen seasons weren't very good, but this was where I started to get to accept the CGI series to start, despite not enjoying the first few seconds of it, which is kind of odd since there were people who thought it was pretty good. But yeah, I did begin to enjoy what I was watching during the race between Thomas and Spencer. Number three, Blue Mountain Mystery. Number four, The Adventure Begins. And number five, Legend of the Lost Treasure, which will surprise no one, obviously. And for my honorable mentions, I'm probably going to go with, like, King of the Railway and Tale of the Brave and Journey Beyond Sodor. I did think Big World Big Adventures was average. Question 16. Which season is your favourite? Season 5. Question 17. What do you think of Bob the Builder? Now, I used to watch Bob the Builder when I was a kid. My brother had a few VHS tapes of it. And I used to watch it on Nick Jr. a bit. And I was a huge fan of Bob the Builder, but not as much after I started getting into Thomas and Friends. But I did watch the show on Nick Jr. though. The last time I actually watched a new episode of Bob the Builder was like an episode from Ready Steady Build in 2011 on the BBC iPlayer at school, which was I think it was around the time they had to temporarily move to Standhouse because of the school got flooded. I could be wrong though, but needless to say, the last new Bob Builder episode I watched was something from 25th, was from like Ready Steady Build in 2010. But then in 2015, I heard about the announcement of the reboot, and I was not too keen on the idea. And then in 2016, I decided to go back and rewatch the series, along with watching the US dub of Bob the Builder for the first time, which is alright, to say the least. And in 2018, I did watch some episode from 2015 Bob Builder, and it was pretty bad. And as I said before, I don't understand too much like James A. Williams when it comes to the 2015 Bob Builder reboot, so yeah. And also, I think my favourite special from Bob the Builder had to be A Christmas to Remember, because I had some good memories with that one. Question 18. 2016 or 2020? Neither, because they were both terrible. Although in 2016 was the year I started doing sprites, and most of them look bad. I mean, really, really bad. But I'm not really too proud of my older content, so I'm probably not going to showcase any of them. And 2020 was the year I started using trains, and I still do to in present day, seen in my remake of the Rosu Story Museum piece, and I haven't really done a video with trains for a while, but I've done a handful of screenshots with that. So yeah, put it simply, neither of them are pretty bad. Question 18. If you were on Sodor, where would you like to work? I'd say the Scarlery Railway as a volunteer. Much like how I'm going to be a volunteer on the Talilin Railway at some point in the future. Question 19. What is your favorite Disney movie? Okay, well, my favorite Disney movie or movies are The Aristocats, 101 Dalmatians, including the direct-to-home video sequel, the two TV shows, like 101 Dalmatians the series and 101 Dalmatian Street. I wasn't really a huge fan of the live-action movies, though, but I did think 102 Dalmatians was decent, though. Lady and the Tramp, that includes its direct-to-DVD sequel. Fox and the Hound, I did used to like Fox and the Hound 2, but haven't watched it in a long time, but I could kind of tell it's not a very good movie. As such, as I kind of want to deem it as non-canon, since it's more of a mid-quel in a way, but yeah, I still regard Fox and the Hound 2 non-canon, to say the least. Bambi, that includes Bambi 2. Toy Story, that include, along with like Toy Story 1, including like Toy Stories 1, 2, 3. I haven't seen Lightyear yet, but I'm hoping to soon. Buzz Lightyear, Star Command, eventually. I've only seen the pilot movie for the TV show, though. I did watch one episode around 2019. I did think Toy Story 4 was good, but my opinion kind of changed on it after seeing Gondarf's review on Toy Story 4 in his Video Memories episode of Toy Story. So yeah, Toy Story 4 was a bit of a feeble sequel, and especially since Toy Story 3 had a nice ending. Monsters, Inc. Cars 1 and 3. I did think Cars 2 was a good movie, but over time I did come to accept the fact that it was not a good movie. The Lion King. Along with, like, The Lion King 2. I have not seen The Lion King 3, though.
Those are my favorite Disney movies. Plus, I did think The Jungle Book, Beauty and the Beast, The Little Mermaid, Zootropolis, and, Inside Out, along with, like, Coco and The Incredibles were pretty good. Question 19. Will Smudger be in your series? Well, technically, he already has. He made a minor role in Luke's Day Out, but he will make a appearance in the Halloween special for this year, but I'm not going to give away any spoilers because I want to remain spoiler free. Question 19. What kind of music do you like? No, was it 20? I'm not sure. Rock and roll. Question 21. Who is your favorite Thomas narrator? Okay. My favorite narrators are Michelangelo, George Carlin, Alec Baldwin in season 5. He was pretty terrible in season 6. Mark Morgahan, Rilly Rushton, and Ted Robbins. I know they're Rose Susan Reyes, but they kind of count in a way. And for some of the non-English narrators I like, they are Leo Morimoto and Manfred Stephan. And you're probably surprised I didn't mention Ringo Starr, but it's mostly because, like, Ringo Starr wasn't a great narrator. He did an alright job at narrating, but there are some character voices that he did badly, which only got worse when he redubbed them for Shining Time Station. Okay. Question 24. Sorry, I kind of started to lose count. Who is your favorite villain? Diesel 10 in Thomas and Magic Road, at least. as mediocre as Thomas the Magic Red was, at least it was the only time where Diesel 10 was portrayed as a serious threat. Zorin from Tugs, Robbie Rotten from Lazy Town, I think it mostly because of the We Are Number One meme, and Jasper and Horace from 101 Dalmatians. Question 25, thoughts on the reboot? Okay, I do agree that All Engines Go is terrible, but I did take some creative liberties by doing a couple of edits. I think my favorite one had to be when I did like 10 Cents and Sunshine in the style of All Engines Go by using the Salty Zaius pictures of them. I know Salty Zaius is also really terrible, but still. And plus, I've also made my own versions of Kana and Sandy and Bruno. Even though I'm kind of contradicting myself and probably just have my version of Bruno just a CGI version of him, which is just the motorized Bruno with a custom CGI face. Question 26. What would happen if a rich guy ran up to your door and say, "Take all your money. Take all my money, I'm rich now," and left you with 7k bucks? What would you do with them? Not sure. Question 27. Have you ever heard of tea cereal? It's cool. Never heard it. Question 27. What customs are you proud of which, and ones that you're not proud of? The one that I'm most proud of is probably Bloomer, which I took inspiration from the Mr. Train Tracks custom pushing on Bloomer, that the custom table on Bloomer that he made, which made me make my own custom Bloomer, which you've seen in like How Baz and Bernie Stole Christmas. The one I'm not so proud of, any of my older customs from 2016, or like any that before I started using paint, because they look pretty terrible. And my narrow gauge customs in my Duncan Duncan remake are enough evidence of that. I think I started peaking with custom making when I started using Humbrol and Amalfur customs, and I'm a bit better. Question 28. Favorite Thomas character that didn't appear in more episodes? Maybe Hank. He had potential to be a good character, along with like Molly, Neville, Dennis, Billy to an extent, because had Billy had a character arc, then he wouldn't be as hated as much. Although I'm thinking of doing an adaptation of Don't Be Silly Billy, where he is portrayed as a clumsy engine rather than a whiny little, well, sod who says this line.
Thomas, huffed Billy, stop telling me what to do. You are a very bossy engine.
So yeah, Hank had the potential to be a good character, but they just used him in one episode and never appeared again, so gonna go with Hank on that one. Question 29? Favourite American steam engines or British steam engines? American, I'm not sure. British, probably the LNER A3 Pacific. Or the B12s. Along with like the LNER A4s as well. Question 30? What other shows other than Thomas and Friends? Modern day are classics. I've already mentioned it before, as seen in like the first one and the favorite Disney movie one. Question 32. Ever heard of Mac Whitman? If so, what performances from her do you like? I don't think I've heard of her before. Sorry. Question 33. Favorite YouTubers, both Thomas and non-Thomas. I'm gonna go with like Enterprise Engine 93, Wild Norwester, The Unlucky Tug. Those are my favorite Thomas YouTubers. along with Thomas 1, Edward 2, Henry 3 as well, and the real Xbox nerd. That's one of my favourite non-Thomas YouTubers. I'm going to have to go with Uncle Al for that one. Because, well, not because I did a remake of one of his episodes of the Krusty Cooch Chronicles once, but I found his videos to be pretty funny. Question 33, I think. What is your favourite and worst favourite customs? As I said before, it was, favourite was Blue Man, least favourite anything before I started using Humbrol, I'm guessing. Question 34, favourite songs? Okay. I've got quite a lot, but I can tell you some of my favourite Thomas songs. They are, like, Thomas's Anthem, or Thomas We Love You, Really Useful Engine, Rules and Regulations, The Island Song, Come for the Ride, The Locomotion, Five New Engines in the Shed, The Sound Song, Every Day's a Special Day on Sodor, Togetherness, Thomas You're the Leader, Go Go Thomas, Day of the Diesels, well, the song, not the special, Working Together, Blue Man Mystery, It's Gonna Be a Great Day, I'll Tell the Brave, Let's Be Brave, Never Overlook a Little Engine, We Make a Team Together, Streamlining, The Hottest Place in Town, and Free and Easy, despite Ace being a douchebag and all. Question 35? Who is your favourite Thomas YouTuber? As I said before, they are The Unlucky Tug, Thomas 1023, Wild Norwester, and Enterprise Engine 93, and along with Thomas Wooden Rally and so on. Question 35. Will you ever do Tug's remakes? I did consider doing a remake of a Theater Tugboat episode at one time, because I was thinking of getting a Urton Northumberland, but I still don't have one. So yeah, although I technically already did, because I did do an episode of my Thomas series called Quarantine, which is essentially a adaptation of the Tugs episode with the same name. Question 36. Favorite Tomy item you have? So I'm not quite sure. I'm gonna have to think about that one. It'll probably be most of the Playrail stuff. Like, mostly Promos and CGI characters, even though some of them are a bit hit and miss, like Connor having, Kim having weird faces, Ryan having, not having a painted wheel, and yeah. Question 37. What are your plans in the near future of your series? Well, I didn't want to give any spoilers away, but for season 4, I've actually been thinking of doing, like, some episodes that were going to be in a mini-series called The Early Days of the Sodor Rally, but I ended up cancelling it after I lost the scripts because they got wiped out, along with most of my downloads, so some of them will have to be included as part of Series 4, like, with the 98462 episodes. Also, just to put it out there, he is not called Alfred in my series, he is called Clyde, because I thought it'd be more fresher than copying Soto Dark Times and NWR Origins. Question 41. Do you like Angry Birds? I did see the Angry Birds movie back in 2016, I thought it was alright, and I did see the Angry Birds movie 2, and I thought it was pretty good. Question 41. What character do you think fits well in the Railway series from the hit era? Probably Molly or Neville. And I kind of had a thought that Billy and Charlie are kind of canon to the Railway series in a way. I know that Charlie is from the CGI series, but it was mostly because that slides from one of the roads of Sodor lectures that Wilbur Aldrin made revealed that two Wellsman Sodor tank engines were like Manning Ward L class 060 STSs. So I kind of thought that kind of implied that Billy and Charlie were canon to the Railway series. Question 42. Have you seen Charlie Chalk before?
I have. I think my first experience to it was the song I'm the Boss, which I heard in one of Eli J. Roney's New Engine Sideshow videos. And it was also heard in like part 3 of Generation 1 of Kudo the Tank Engine, which was originally done the original series by Felix Chain, and I was the one who actually figured it. And I was actually the one who figured out where the song came from. So yeah, question 42, or 41, I kind of lost count, sorry. What is your favourite other Thomas lines besides Tomy? I'm gonna go with like Ertl, take and play before they got upgraded with the wooden railway style magnets, which is a downgrade. Adventures, Backman, Hornby, Thomas Engine Collection Series, Nakayoshi, and Capsule Play Rail, which I do like. Question 43. How is your animation so good? I think it probably has to do with the fact that I actually can animate mouth movements, which not many people do. And I kind of took some inspiration from D. Coleman H. with his behind-the-scenes video of his remake on Tomy Toad's Adventure. And I guess his Tank Engine Chad and Friends series? Question 43. Do you like other shows aside from Thomas? I've already said that. Question 44. Why do you like making videos? I'm going to say because it's really good. Even though most of my older views from 2015 to 2018 are really bad, and some are a little hit and miss, although I do have fun making them. Question 45. Thoughts on Thomas's American spin-off Shining Time Station? Okay, my first experience to Shining Time Station was with Thomas and the Magic Road, where we got some of the human characters like Mr. Conductor, Stacey Jones, Lily, Billy Two Feathers, and Bernard Stowe. But I think I first watched a full episode of Shining Time Station around 2012, I believe. And basically, I think Shining Time Station is really good. And a very interesting part of Thomas, the history of Thomas, in a way. So yeah, I'd say Shining Time Station is pretty good. Question 46. Thoughts on the cut pushed forward episodes of Series 21, like Rebecca's episodes and Fear of Fireworks, etc. Okay, I thought, like, what Rebecca does and, like, Confusion and Delay were good. I kind of had a thought that would have Rebecca been a little bit better if she was introduced in Season 21 as intended. Because I know a lot of people hate Nee and Rebecca. I don't. I like Rebecca, and I think Nia is alright. Fear of Fireworks. I'm actually thinking on adapting, like, Fear of Fireworks, like, with Oliver in Samson's role, like, how it should be. So, yeah. I did think Chuckleson Truck should have been written better. And as it's been recently confirmed by Sam Wilkinson, the mystery of the puzzling parts, the case of the puzzling parts, sorry, was actually going to be part of the 21st season, so kind of curious to what the other three were. Question 47, I think. Favorite class of steam engine? I like the LNER A3s, the A4s, the B12s, as I said before, along with like the LNER J50s, which is
my basis for Edwin the LNR J50. Question 48. Which role consultant do you prefer, David Mamet or Sam Wilkinson? Probably, David Mamet. Hit Entertainment should have brought him back for season 17. And plus, I actually bumped into Sam Wilkinson while I was at the Audrey Extravaganza this year. And while I didn't record it, I actually met the unlucky Tug while I was there. And I asked him if he was going to do a Sodor's Finest on Duke the Lost Engine. Least favourite Rogue series, only character and book. Okay, part of me wants to say Ivor Hugh because, like, he appears in the very last story and he doesn't have any lines. Although, I did give him some bits of dialogue in my series, like in Luke's Day Out, where Luke is like, do you know where Jane and Mabel are? And Ivy's like, oh, they're in that little shit over there. He says, thank you. And, like, then, like, Rusty gets it done where he was, like, pulling, like, the first train. He was like, oh, you did a grand job, Rusty. And Rusty's like, thank you, Ivor Hugh. Yeah, I kind of want to say Ivor Hugh, but at the same time, I kind of don't. And as for my least favorite book, probably New Little Engine. Funny, since this was the book Ivor Hugh was introduced in, like, and I kind of felt Jock the New Engine did the concept a lot better. So yeah, I kind of want to say Ivor Hugh, but at the same time I kind of don't. Thoughts on Hey Arnold? Haven't really seen the show. Biggest guilty pleasure in terms of media? Something you enjoy that others don't? I watched The Buzz on Maggie in, last year, and which is one of Disney's failed shows of the 2000s. Kind of like how The Cramped Twins was one of Cartoon Network's failed shows of the 2000s. But I'm gonna have to go with that. Favorite Thomas characters? I've already said that. Favorite costume we've done so far? Bloomer. I know I've already said that him before, but still. Do you know a username Railfan number one? Yes! He's also the voice actor for Rex and Frank in my Thomas series, as seen like Out of the Snow, Out in the Snow, How Baz and Bernie Stole Christmas, and Eddie and the Gnomes. And plus, he also said he was also going to do a Q&A for Hit the 5th anniversary of his channel, kind of like me, in a way. What other shows are you interested in besides Thomas and Tugs? I've already said that, but I'll make it quick. Pingu, Post and Pat, Fireman Sam, Bob the Builder, the originals, obviously. Tom and Jerry, Looney Tunes, although I've actually watched Tom and Jerry a lot more than Looney Tunes, which is kind of a bigger shock. Yeah, The Simpsons, Rex the Runner, as I've said before. Along with Theo Tubbert as well. I know I've already said those before, but still. Favourite Tomy Trimaster model? For Tomy, okay, I think I've kind of got a more fleshed out answer here. Probably, like, Streamline Thomas. I know it's plural, but it kind of counts. Because I think the free speeds option was pretty solid. And Trackmaster, I'm gonna go with Steven. Along with, like, Bertram as well, because Steven was the last great Trackmaster before the Trackmaster 2 happened and the line kind of went to crap. Well, I know Porter was also released before the redesign, but still. As for Trackmaster 2, most of them are ranged from, like, average to bad or just plain terrible. But I did think the motorized stuff was actually really solid. Before they started making, like, all engines go motorized toys, but still, Yeah, I'm gonna go with that. As a hit toy company, I'm probably gonna go with, like, the Flip Face James, because I'm quite happy to have him, even if he's, well, in pretty bad condition. Favorite season? I've already said that. Season 5? Can I voice an OC in your series? Okay, well, I know you're voicing Ted, that's a given, but I'm not sure who else is of what other OCs are available right now. What is your favourite Thomas movie? I've already mentioned the top 5 as well. Who is your favourite Thomas character? I've kind of already answered that. Have you ever voiced in my videos before? Not really. Remember last year when you made the video about Pots and Queens? Well, actually it was Duck and Duke, so I haven't really done Paint Pots and Queens. It might become as a big shot because, like, in regards to, I could have made one for the Queen's Diamond Jubilee. Although I did do, like, Thomas and the Fat Controller's engines, so I technically did something for the Jubilee, but still. What kind of music do you like to listen to? Mostly rock and roll. What movies do you like? I've already mentioned, like, the Disney movies that I like, but I did see, like, Sonic the Hedgehog 2 a few months ago, and I thought it was really good. Same with the first movie as well. Thought that was very solid. Would you like to be in a series called Dominic and Friends? Okay, sure, I'll be happy to. What is your favourite Thomas merchandise? Can't really mention that. What is the best part on YouTube for making your series? Probably filming, I'm gonna go with, like, which Thomas and Friends toys are the best to use when making your own Thomas and Friends videos? Oh god, yeah. It kind of varies, like, Tomy, Trackmaster, Playrail, along with, like, Capsule, Playrail, and Urta, which I've been using for the minimum gauge engines. And only fairly recently, I started using Nakayoshi Urtel Thomas Engine Collection Series Take Long and Take and Play for the narrow gauge engines. Name your favourite Railway Series, TV series, and CJ coders. For Railway Series, Neil. TV series, Derek, Diesel, Ted, Emily, and Molly. And Rosie as well. CGI, Hero, Rebecca, Connor, and, God. Sonny, I didn't quite mention him. I know I didn't really mention him earlier, but still. It must be nice to share your love for Thomas and Friends with everyone. True, true. Out of all the YouTubers who do their own Thomas and Friends series, name 6 you like to watch the most. Enterprising Engines, Rail Fan Number 1, I can't really name any more. Along with, like, well, I do know, like, Wild Norwester is one of them. I'm not sure what to put for the last 6, though. If you had to be a Thomas and Friends character, which type of engine class would you want to be in from what railway? Well, in case you may know, my train sonar is basically, like, Donald or Douglas painted blue with, like, a Peter Sam's funnel, which is not shown on the little wooden railway model I made for him, with a James Tender painted blue with number 77 and, well, he has his own railway initials on him, NSR, which is, like, North Sodor Railway. I think I did consider... I think there are some times I considered making this into a series, but basically, the North Sodor Railway is Sodor's second standard gauge railway, and I came up with it around 2016 when I had started doing Thomas Sprites, and there were quite a lot of... And I think there were some characters I had to retcon because either they were... Although I do remember, although there are some engines that are not included, although I haven't quite touched the roster in a long time, although the original one I made from 2016 is painfully out of date, but I do remember, like, that that Spencer and Tornado are actually going to be part of the railway. Along with, like, the Backroom Junior E2s, plus, I think, Digby as well, but, and mostly Takadam, but I also had a little series around the time called Mr. Thompson's Railway, in which mostly the two Backroom Junior E2s, one of them being called, the red one being called Davey and Billy, which, for some reason, I made the Backroom Junior Billy and the Hornby 040 E2 Billy the same character, which was the same design as Mosley. And I kind of did like an episode, Billy got into a crash and was rebuilt into the Backroom Junior Billy. So, yeah, and the original one was very out of date, and they were quite, and I haven't really updated it in a long time, so it's very outdated. Although the last new additions to it were one of Percy's friends from, like, the Rosie version of Percy Takes the Plunger. Tara, the Blue Engine, no relationship to Tara Strong. 1020, the Old Engine, and Albert. Even though Albert has appeared in my series, if you haven't seen Bertie Lends a Hand, and he is set to appear, like, and I did plan for him to appear in Season 4 in an episode where Victoria goes back to working with Albert, and Toby goes to work with, like, the Quarryman's coach from Wilbur Tawdry's layout, which was kind of foreshadowed in Bertie Lends a Hand. What do you like best about Tom's Friends? I'm not sure. Do you think Henry would have still worked in his old shape if he had just been given a larger firebox when he went to crew? I kind of want to say no on that one, but needless to say, the TV series kind of got there, kind of got the answer. But either way, the TV series kind of got that answered, despite the removal of his wheel arches, although he did regain them in Season 2. Would you accept ideas for new videos for those who watch them if it will help your channel grow? I did make a community tab of which episodes from the hit model era that I should adapt for my series, and some of them are like Don't Be Silly Billy, Edward Strikes Out, which I did consider for Season 3 but was dropped, but it got dropped because Rocky had already been introduced, and Missing Trucks, which I'm going to be adapting, and Reneus and the Dinosaur, but with Handel and Duncan's role, and Scarlet Storm 2, but with Scarlet and Peter Sam's role swapped around. Basically having Peter Sam in Scarlet's role and Scarlet and Peter Sam's role. That would have made the episode a little bit better. And someone did ask, like, for Wonky Whistle and Up, Up and Away, but those are from the hit. Those are from the Nitrogen era. Who is your favourite Thomas character? I kind of already answered that. What's your favourite Thomas movie? I've kind of already answered that. What's your favourite colour? I've already answered that. What is the proudest custom you've made? Tell me, Trump's custom you've made. I was quite pleased with how Bloomer turned out, despite being a push-along, but yeah, he's a push-along, but he kind of counts. Although I didn't really include any push-alongs in my Tommy Trouser and Pearl Collection, aside from Nord, Jahan, and Wickham. How many engines do you have? Quite a lot. What's the first engine you have ever got? I'm not sure. If you're talking about Ertl, I kind of want to say Douglas. I could be wrong, though. But yeah, as for Tommy Transform Player, I'm not really sure. I do know for a fact that Trapmaster 2 Gorm was the first Trapmaster 2 item that I got, which I mean to, like, Old Shape Henry in his blue livery, and the first motorized items I got were Shane and Kenji, which I got in, like, July 2020. And my first player art engine I got was, like, the Persian, the little Persian, the circus cars pack that I got for Christmas 2014. How is your day going?
It's going alright.
Who is your least favourite Thomas character? Kind of the same as everyone else's, like Charlie and the Logging Locos. Although I kind of want to say Stefano because he was pretty much just made to sell toys.
Can you show me your top 5 Thomas customers you've made so far?
Bloomer, the custom narrow gauge coaches, because the reception to them were pretty good on Twitter. Ernest and Stevie, because not many people have made a Stevie before.
My 16 custom, because I thought it was a mage improvement over the original. And for the 5th one, not really sure. Probably the Coldy Fell engines, because they were received well. Well, mostly the newer ones. The only one that did not get upgraded to a Trapmaster Freddy was Wilfred.
But I'm not sure why exactly. Probably when, like, in 2019 or 2020, I just decided not to give Wilfred a new model and just have him retain his old model.
What is your top favourite non-Thomas shows? I've kind of already mentioned that. So yeah, and that's about it. Thank you all for some of your comments, thank you all for all the support over the last 5 years. Thank you all for your subscribing, and yeah. And thank you all for watching, and I'll see you all next time with either the next episode of Season 3 or the first story of Bad Faced Thomas and his friends. And yeah, thank you very much.